What is up, everybody? Today I'm going to count down my 10 favorite albums from 1984. Another really great year with a lot of awesome classic albums. As usual, just my opinion here, and I'll give some honorable mentions after I say my number two. Here we go. Young boy, I hopped him right. I'm a loose again. Starting off the list at number 10 is Great White's self-titled debut album. Really awesome stuff here. It's more of a straightforward classic heavy metal album as opposed to their later releases, which were more like bluesy hard rock, which I do like a lot. I'm a big Great White fan, but this one I've always liked the best. Mark Kendall, amazing guitar player, lots of great riffs and solos throughout the album. Jack Russell, one of the freaking best vocalists of all time. 10 songs, looking at these, you know, a couple favorites I'd say are Bad Boys for sure. Street Killer, On Your Knees, Nightmares, Dead End. A lot of great stuff here. Highly recommend this album. Great White, self-titled, number 10. Next up at number 9 is Burning the Witches by Warlock. Really great band from Germany. One of my all-time favorite German metal bands. Rudy Graf and Peter Zaghetti on guitar. Really great duo. Lots of great riffs and solos all over this album. Doro Pesch, of course, on vocals. Really great, unique voice. And looking at this track listing, a lot of great stuff, but a few favorites I'd say are the opening track, Sign of Satan, for sure. Very Judas Priest type of style metal here on this album. Dark Fade, really amazing. Probably my favorite song on it. Homicide Rocker's great. Metal Racer, the title track. Just overall, very strong album. Wish I could put it higher. But so many great classic albums from 84. Gotta put it at number 9, Burning the Witches by Warlock. Power Slave by Iron Maiden comes in at number 8. Really good classic album. Might be a little lower than some of y'all have it, but I gotta put it here. Looking at the track listing, a couple favorite songs I'd say are Aces High, 2 Minutes to Midnight, Flash of the Blade, and the title track. Of course, Rime of the Ancient Mariner is a really good classic song as well. Back in the Village, I think that's another good song. I've seen some people say that's filler in the past. Highly disagree with that statement, but this is the second album with my favorite lineup of the band. Nico McBrain on the drums, Adrian Smith and Dave Murray on guitar, Steve Harris on the bass, and Bruce Dickinson, of course, on vocals. Great lineup, great performances from everybody in the band. And if I had to predict, I'd probably say in the comments this would be maybe the most picked to number one from you guys. But for me, gotta put it at number 8 right now, Power Slave by Iron Maiden. Coming in at number 7 is The Warning by Queensryche. Amazing album. Brutal trying to put this together because all of these are great. But the lineup, of course, you got Jeff Tate on vocals, who is amazing. One of my favorite singers of all time. Chris DeGarmo and Michael Wilton on the guitar. Great duo. Very awesome guitar work on this album and all the stuff they did together. But Eddie Jackson on the bass and Scott Rockenfield on the drums. Looking at these songs, a lot of great stuff. Warning, Enforced, Deliverance, No Sanctuary, NM156 is a really awesome song. Take Hold of the Flame, Before the Storm, Child of Fire, and Roads to Madness. Just overall, very solid, consistent, great album here. Probably my second favorite Queensryche album, just behind Operation Mindcrime. But yeah, great album, The Warning, number 7. Tooth and Nail by Dokken comes in at number 6. Great album from a great band. The lineup they had at this point was incredible. You got George Lynch on the guitar. Great riffs, great solos, amazing tone. Mr. Scary himself, the guy's a beast. Don Dokken on vocals, who has a great melodic, smooth, angel-like sounding voice. Jeff Pilson on the bass and Mick Brown on drums rounding out the lineup. This track listing, a lot of awesome stuff. The way the album opens up, it's got that Without Warning song, kind of a little intro into the title track. Really great stuff there, you know, looking at the rest. Heartless Heart's a really good song, Don't Close Your Eyes. When Heaven Comes Down, Alone Again is probably one of the better ballads of the 80s in my opinion. Really good stuff. Into the Fire, another great one. And of course, the final track, Turn on the Action. Amazing. But very solid, consistent, good album here. Tooth and Nail, number 6. Coming in at number 5 is Ride the Lightning by Metallica. Great album, and yeah, I've made fun of Metallica in the past. Pretty easy to do based off what they've done in the last 25 years or so. But, you know, those first two albums especially, still really good. This one here, you know, it's got 8 songs on it, a lot of classics. Opening song, Fight Fire with Fire, is awesome. The title track and For Whom the Bell Tolls, probably my favorites. But, you know, Creeping Death is really good. Escape, the kind of forgotten song from the album, is pretty good. Fade to Black, Call of Cthulhu, really good instrumental to close out the album. Just overall, very strong album here. Ride the Lightning, number 5. Next up at number 4 is Don't Break the Oath by Merciful Fate. Killer album and band, very influential to extreme metal, black metal in particular. These guys were a part of the first wave of black metal with bands like Venom, Celtic Frost, Bathory. Out of those bands, Merciful Fate easily the best in my opinion. Their music though, probably the least black metal sounding, just the lyrics, very evil and dark. The songs here on this album, 9 of them, a lot of great stuff, but some favorites I'd say are Desecration of Souls, Come to the Sabbath, and The Oath, for sure my favorites. Michael Denner and Hank Sherman, great duo, both amazing. Kim Bendix Peterson, aka King Diamond, on the vocals, amazing range, one of my favorite singers of all time. Just overall, fantastic album here, Don't Break the Oath, number 4. Defenders of the Faith by Judas Priest comes in at number 3. Got the shirt, got the cassette tape. Amazing album here. Looking at these tracks, Free Will Burning, the opener. One of the best opening tracks in all of metal history, in my opinion. Jawbreaker, Rock Hard Ride Free, The Sentinel, Love Bites, Eat Me Alive, Some Heads Are Gonna Roll. Just a lot of amazing stuff here. Rob Halford on vocals, favorite metal vocalist of all time. KK Downing and Glenn Tipton. Another amazing guitar duo. I've ranked them number 1 in the past, best metal guitar duo of all time. Ian Hill on the bass and Dave Holland on the drums. Just a great classic album here, Defenders of the Faith, number 3. Taking the number 2 spot is the self-titled debut from Wasp. Great album, I've talked about it in several other videos. Wasp, one of my favorite bands of all time. Blackie Lawless, amazing, great, unique voice. Tony Richards on the drums, and Randy Piper and Chris Holmes on the guitar. Just overall, great lineup, great band. Amazing songs on here. Some of my favorites, I'd say, are I Wanna Be Somebody, Love Machine, probably Hellion, and The Torture Never Stops, but very strong from start to finish. My number 2 album of 1984, Wasp, self-titled. And as usual, got a lot of honorable mentions. Some very tough ones I had to leave off. Disillusion by Loudness, really great. Wings of Tomorrow by Europe, which I thought I had sitting here on cassette tape. Yeah, it's right here. Very good album. Europe, the first 2 albums, very awesome. What else I got listed here? Night of the Blade by Tokyo Blade, really great album. Metal Church, self-titled debut, which is up on the wall on vinyl I have up there. You can't see it in the screen though. Love at First Sting by Scorpions. Rising Force by Yngwie Malmsteen. I've got that one right here. Amazing guitarist, but the album didn't quite make the list. Still very good though. Lay Down the Law by Keel. Really good stuff. Projects in the Jungle by Pantera. Yes, it's a good album, people. Bathory, self-titled debut. Fistful of Metal by Anthrax. Animalize by Kiss. Power Games by 220 Volt. March of the Saints by Armored Saint. The Last in Line by Dio. Yes, there's more, but that's all I've got for honorable mentions. And on to my number 1. Taking the number 1 spot is Out of the Cellar by Rat. One of my absolute favorite albums of all time. I've said it in multiple videos in the past. I'll probably say it again in the future. Love everything about this album. The guitar playing is incredible from Warren DeMartini and Robin Crosby. Really good unique vocals from Stephen Piercy. Bobby Blotzer on the drums does a really good job. And Juan Crozier, however you say his last name, good on the bass as well. So overall, very strong album. Looking at these songs, Wanted Man, the opening song, is awesome. You're in Trouble, Round and Round, In Your Direction, She Wants Money, Lack of Communication, Back for More, The Morning After, I'm Insane, maybe my favorite on the album, definitely top three, and Scene of the Crime. Extremely consistent, great album here, Out of the Cellar. My number one album of 1984. That does wrap up the list. As usual, let me know what you thought. Give me your ranking in the comments. And until next time, thank you for watching.